was this problem that you did on Bellwork, how was that different from the other order of operation problems that we've been working on? How is that different? Asia?
Because you're having, like, instead of doing the work, you have to pick which one you're into.
Instead of actually doing the work, you had to pick what you would do to find the answer. That's a little different than what we've been working on, right? Yesterday, it just said evaluate numerical expressions. Today, we're also going to work on writing them. I think all of you can follow PEMDAS, but today, we're going to actually work on applying some of this a little differently. In my sixth grade classroom today, we worked in stations to reinforce order of operations and how to solve numerical expressions. My students have been working on this skill previously for a couple of days, and today we were using more of application skills in showing their knowledge of solving numerical expressions. Your first station is error analysis. We do this a lot. We find the errors or mistakes that are made in a problem. We've really been focusing on the difference between mistakes and errors lately, because in math, mistakes are made more often because we rush and because we want to be finished and because we want to be the fastest, which is just kind of human nature. But as a teacher, I have to know the difference between, is a student just working too fast, or is a student actually not understanding what to do or what comes next. So for me, it's been an important difference to be able to make between the two. What's the difference in a mistake and an error? I feel you have to provide an environment where it's safe to make mistakes. Students don't usually come in feeling super confident in their math skills, so I want them to know that it's okay to make errors. What order do I work this to make this true? This is probably one of the most difficult stations you're going to deal with today, and I'll be available to help you, okay? Don't get discouraged. That's why we do these activities where we're interacting and kind of giving feedback to one another, because I want them to know everything you do is not assessed for accuracy. It's okay that you're making these errors now so that when you are assessed for accuracy, you'll be prepared. Your instructions are on here. It says solve a problem, rotate your paper, and Kendall will check John's work. What would be the polite way to let John know he has done something incorrectly? Not like some of us like to do. Some of us like to say, that's wrong, you did that wrong. We typically work in stations, usually once a week or once every couple of weeks. It allows the students to engage with one another. It builds cooperative learning. Sometimes when I can't maybe explain or give feedback, the students, they respond well to one another. So it gives them some opportunities to hear from their peers and just learn how to work well with others and build social skills. Okay, so how could you figure out how many cookies that is altogether? In anything that we do in the classroom, I try to be there and I try to give positive feedback. Even if I am critiquing something that they're working on, I try to do it in a positive way. I think it's a culture that you build up and you model the type of students you want to build and create. You just tried that first? So you kind of just tried a set around something to see if it gave you that answer. I think that's perfect. I help students solve problems by using the mathematical practices that we've been taught. It's really helped me reflect on my teaching practices, and so we focus on those a lot. Just being persistent, just persevering when something is difficult, and that's what I feel like stations help with a lot. What did Adanelli do that tells me I have to do? Yes, good. And I'm always available. I'm just available for questions. I want to help guide them to the right place when they're struggling. No, your second one is on a different card. So often we give them work to do, and if they don't understand the directions, they certainly aren't going to do the work correctly. So just making sure they understand what's asked of them. I want you to have time to work with each station, even if you don't get finished with all three. But make sure you're putting them all back in the sleeve and then pass them on.